is Josué Ríos, and we and my partners are Javier Pacheco and Luis Villa, and we are going to present our second part of the project report. The main objective of the second partial project is to do the structural analysis of tapered steel portal frames for a basketball arena at a high school that is located on the coast of Cancun, Mexico. We should design and propose the dimensions and height so that a typical basketball court, 15 meters per 28 meters, can be placed inside, including stands on both sides. We should also consider a 336 steel, a young modulus of 20 gigapascal, and a value of FY250 megapascal. In the first step, we have to define the structure. We decide to use the conventional beams and based on the size of dimensions of the frame. Based on of those dimensions of the basketball court, we can propose the dimensions of the portal frame with variable sections that is support the roof and the wind loads. That we needed to assign and cross sections for the beams and columns to determine the area and inertia across the frame. This is the values of our measures. Occur this those data as we propose them.
Based on those dimensions, we propose a frame for our basketball arena, and then we decided that we will use a variable section of 30 centimeters to 75 centimeters and a height of 10 meters and the length of 25 meters.
Then here the stands, we make an investigation that each person should use 50 centimeters, 10-50 centimeters to have a good seat. The stance is 50 times 50 for each person, so the measures were 12.5 times 5, the length. And then each person should have like 0.25 square meters to sit, and it's 50 persons per stand. Then the court, that it's 28 meters times 15, and the total area is 420. Then the dimension of the structure, it's the area, it's gonna be 25 times 31, because we consider the stands for the substitute of each team, the judge table, and the structure, so it will be 25 times 31, and the height will be of 10, so there it's 775. And then the stands for each team, the reglamentary ones were 9 meters 10.5, and it's 18 persons per each stand.
For the steel cross section, we chose two different ones, one for the column and one for the beam. We chose the HEB 600, and we just varied like the depth of the cross section, but the width, the web thickness, and the flange thickness will be the same. And for the beam, we chose the IPE 500 with those dimensions and with the variable depth from 750 to 350 millimeters, and with the same width, web thickness, and flange thickness. And you can see here that we divided the span of the beam in 10 elements, and we had different inertia and different areas.
Then the loads, we consider three different loads: the gravitational forces, the forces due to wind, and the combination of gravitational and wind loads. Then the gravitational forces, we, for the canvas, it's the density, the weight, the area, and its total weight is 585, almost 600. Then the distributed load of the roof, the tributary width is 4.4, the distributed load 2.7, and the distributed load in newtons meters, square meters is 26.07. Then the wind loads, it depends on the terrain categories. We choose a category T3 that starts with a plain terrain with few obstructions. Here's the table where we take it from. The terrain category, it's Reglamento de Construcción Benito Juárez Quintana Roo, 2008. Then it's radial speed. It's, we took it from CFE, and it's speed, it's around 195 kilometers per hour, that it stands for 54.4 meters per second. Then for the temperature and barometric pressure, it's, we use this formula, that is 298, and we divide it, the temperature, the, we took the temperature from Cancun, it's around 25.5, and then the FT, it's 0.99 on this one. Then the design speed, we use all the factors above to get the design speed, that is the FTR, FT, PR, and the F alpha, and then we got the wind design, and for all the heights, it's the same, because it depends on the height, the formula you use, and from 0 to 10, it's the same formula, so all the speed will be 195.28. And then with this, we took the design pressure. The design pressure is gonna be this C times the V times a factor, it's 0.0048. And then it also changed for each height, so the design pressure, it's gonna be, it depends where the structure is, vertical, the pressure, the design pressure will be 3,500, and where it stands for inclined plane, it will be 1,400.
And it also depends when the wind comes from, because if it comes from like direct, it has different factor, and if it comes like after the wind hits, like in the other side, it's called leeward. You have to consider that, and it will be negative in the roof, and it will be the same in the column, the same values, and then we just multiply that pressure for the tributary width, so we can obtain the distributed load, and we can use that in the kit program to calculate our values that we want. And then we analyzed. We just made two analyses, because the roof and self weight is not that big, so we just took into consideration the roof self weight, and then the wind self weight plus the roof. So the roof, the distributed load of the roof, the weight, it will be 26 newtons per meter plus the self weight, and you can see here our shear force diagram. And here the bending moment, we obtain the values, and the maximum value, it will be in the center. Finally, for displacement, that will be 0.005, and the maximum displacement will be in the center of the roof at the top. And then for wind loads, we took into consideration components that we used, and you can see here the total of the loads, including the roof weight and the wind loads. And you can see here our shear force diagram, the bending moment. Here will be the maximum bending moment will be in the left side of the roof because the pressure it's positive. The minimum, like maximum but negative, will be at the other side of the roof because it's the same amount but it varies the sign. The sign is negative, so it will be the bending moment, it's negative. And the displacement, the maximum value is 0.027, and it will be at the center of the span of the roof. And finally, to know if the frame, portal frame, it's being built correctly, we just compare to the maximum allowable displacement. And you can see here that maximum allowable displacement is 0.07 from the column and from the beam. For the beam it's 0.071 and for the column it's 0.07 meters. So the displacement that we obtain is less than the maximum allowed displacement, so it's correctly. So it's allowed to be constructed.
Well, as a conclusion, the wine design is a complex process and an important concept when we are designing a structure. In this case, we analyze a structure that is already done, but as engineers, as civil engineers, we need to take these concepts and not only the wind designs, maybe the earthquake forces, the wind, the snow, and the other will be maybe the ground when we are building the construction. An important concept here that is the how it works the wind design, because on some areas of our frame, in the columns, the forces were in one direction, and in the roof, one was up on the top, and the other is down, because there is a phenomenon of suction. And so it's the behavior is different. Maybe hurricane and waves of the sea when we are building oil plants on the ocean. And in our professional life, we must accomplish with those old concepts of design so we can build safety, economic, and useful buildings in the future. If you have any questions, you can comment or be. Thank you.